Hi. In this video, we will learn how to sign up to mWater, design our first survey, deploy it, and then have it ready on our device so that we can begin collecting data. In future videos, you can learn how to actually conduct the data collection, manage the data as it comes back into the portal, and then build visualizations and share them with any audiences you might want to share them with. But now, let's begin. I'm a new user to mWater, and I want to create a WaterPoint functionality survey. What do I do? First of all, I can navigate to the website, the portal, portal.mwater.co. This is where all the survey design, management, visualization, and sharing can happen. Once I'm on this page, all I need to do is click the sign up button if I don't already have an account, and fill in a few fields. The name, username, which is a unique username, a password, and an email address. We also recommend that you enter the organization you are working for so that we can better connect users of those organizations together and assist them as much as possible. Please also confirm that you're at least 13 years of age. Once I've filled in all the information or used the social media sign up options, I can sign up. This will bring me logged in into the portal, my username learnmwater. And here we will see a number of tabs on the top that we can navigate through. Surveys is what we will focus on today. Maps and dashboards will allow you to visualize what you want to visualize. Through manage, you can manage your sites, points in the world, and other pieces of information. And then there's more advanced functionality we can cover later. You can change your signup details from the top right by selecting My Account. The purpose here is to build a simple WaterPoint functionality survey, so I'm going to focus on the Surveys tab. I'm clicking the top nav bar, Surveys tab, and I get shown a list of all the surveys that have been made visible to me. I want to create a new one, so I click the button Create New Survey. I'm taken to the Survey Design screen, where I see a number of new tabs to look through. We won't cover all of them here, but I'll touch on them briefly. Translate is useful if I want to translate the survey to another language so my enumerators can make sense of it. If I want to see what my survey would look like on a device, I can use the Preview tab. To adjust survey level settings, I go to the Settings tab. I can add confidential data, and I can also add collaborators on the survey. Anything you do on the Settings page affects the survey level permissions. So you can add other collaborators who can design the survey with you, or maybe view it. But this does not activate the survey for any group of users so that it appears on their device. That's what the Deploy tab is for, and we'll get there later. And there's another set of tabs that are more to do with looking at the responses and visualizing them as it pertains to this survey. First of all, we will design the survey. I'm going to give it a name. WaterPoint Functionality Survey. And then, using this mouse-driven interface, I'm simply going to start adding questions. Okay, so I click Add and New Question. Here we have a number of options to choose from in terms of what kind of question type we select. It's useful to think about what's the most useful type for the question you're wanting to ask. Do you want a number, text, single select, multi-select? Are options exclusive? I want to ask, is water available from the water point on the day of the visit? And I choose a simple radio button question. Is water available from the water point on the day of the visit? Because I've chosen a radio button question, which means that only one option out of many options can be selected at a time, I also need to add those options. So below here, I add a choice. Choice of yes, and the other choice, no. I'm almost done. This is an important question for my survey, so I will also mark it as required here on the top right, and then save it. Now I have this radio button question, is water available? And the enumerator for any given survey response can only choose one of the two. Now, the next question I want to ask is how many hours per day is water usually available from this source? So yet again, I add a new question. This time, it's a number question because I'm asking the amount of hours. Again, I type the question text. This is what the enumerator will see. And I can decide whether it's a whole number, just the number of hours, or a decimal number with a comma. I will select a whole number, and then I can do more advanced things, add validations, allow a don't know option. That's what I will do. And I will also make this required. This gives us our second question. Third, I want to have the enumerator take a photo of the water point, so I'll add yet another question. This time, I'll scroll down to make sure I select an image question and give the enumerator an instruction to take a photo of the water point. This will also be required. And finally, I will want to take advantage of the powerful functionality in mWater of having sites. This means points in the world that persist beyond surveys. Imagine, for example, how your Facebook wall persists even as posts come and go. So I want to track a water point site. I choose a site question. And I make sure the site type is water point. There's a number of other sites available. And I make this mandatory as well. When the user is now going to be in the app, they can then select from their map, out of existing sites, the water point site they're visiting. Or if that site does not exist, they will be able to create that. If they make that site to have a privacy level of protected or public, it will then allow other enumerators and other organizations to see the location of this water point. The questions you ask in your survey will still remain private to you, but the location and water point type and other basic properties can thus be made public. So, I've created four questions in my design. It has been saved automatically, and this is all I want to ask right now. So, next, what I want to do is make sure I can actually access that in my device. So I don't want to translate it. I don't need to adjust settings. I want to go straight to deploy. Deploying it means that I'm activating this survey for one or more enumerators. The same survey could be used in different districts, different countries. So that's why there needs to be different deployments with different managers and so on. Going to call this my learning deployment. Going to make sure it's active. And importantly, I'm going to set it to have myself as the enumerator. And I'll also set another account to be the manager. This is not strictly necessary, but this is useful as the data comes through. What does this mean? Enumerators are the people who are able to collect the data and have this survey appear on their device. Viewers will be able to see the responses of this deployment. For example, managers who are not actually in the field and shouldn't be changing the data but will want to see it. Managers will be able to edit and correct information in the surveys and can also send feedback to enumerators to correct them. I will also add an approval stage where my manager account will track it. These are not necessary steps, only the enumerator and a name is necessary. Once I save my deployment, I see that it becomes active. Now that it is active and I've designed it, I can go to my mobile device where I've installed the Surveyor app and see it appear. You can also access the Surveyor app through your browser at app.mwater.co. And that's what I would see, where I can log in with the login I have created. I'm going to select standard user, as I don't have a custom version of the app. And this is the homepage of the app I see. I want to make sure that my three synchronizations have completed: the data upload, image upload, and offline sync. The offline sync is what determines that the design of the survey that we just completed actually gets downloaded onto your device. Now that I see that it's complete, I'm able to start the survey. I can start the survey from the home page on the Start a Survey button, or I can go to the Add button at the bottom and start a survey from there. A few standard surveys already show, and here at the top we see the one we just designed. And here we have the survey we designed, ready to go, be filled in, and be submitted.